Sometimes you'll want to make sure that your final audio file is set to a specific loudness level. This is especially true for podcasts and audiobooks. The podcasting world has adopted an informal standard loudness level of negative 16 LUFS. What is a LUFS? Well, technically, it means loudness units relative to full scale. That clears it right up, doesn't it? Don't worry about the gory details of what all that means. Just know that it is a measure of the average loudness of your audio. LUFS is a measure that better approximates how humans hear audio than the older way of using something called RMS. RMS stands for something called root mean squared, if you care. Again, don't worry about why it's called that. We really wouldn't have to care about this at all if it weren't for Audible's ACX audiobook marketplace. While the rest of the audio world is using LUFS, ACX wants to use RMS, which doesn't really relate to how humans hear audio. It's just math. But ACX wants all audio submitted to them to be between negative 18 decibels and negative 23 dB. Quick reminder that in digital audio, things are kind of backwards. 0 dB is the loudest it can be, and everything else is negative numbers. So negative 18 dB is actually louder than negative 23 dB. Anyway, let's take a look at the basics of saving your audio out at a specific loudness level. Okay, let's look at how to do this in Audacity. Remember I said if you're going to do a podcast, and let's assume this is, that we want a stereo file instead of a mono, even if it's fake stereo by just dividing this into two channels. So let's do that first. Come to Tracks, Add New, Stereo Track. Then double-click up here on the original mono file, right-click, Copy, click down here in the new stereo track, paste. And now move the cursor to the top section until it turns into a hand and drag it very carefully until it locks into place over here. And now we can just delete this top track. Now we have a stereo track. So let's make sure this is selected. Double click it. Go to Effect. Loudness Normalization. Make sure that Perceived Loudness is selected. And enter negative 16. For LUFS. Click OK, and you'll notice that it got louder, but there's a couple of red flags here. These three red lines are showing us that it's going to clip right in those three places because I have, in the View dropdown, Show Clipping selected, which is something that I recommend you do as well. And remember, clipping means that the audio is going to exceed negative 0 dB, and so that's going to distort, and that's not good. So let's just fix these three by zooming into them. Hold down the control button and scroll wheel in to zoom, and you can just highlight until you've got all the red. Go to Effect, Amplify, and let's make the new peak amplitude anything less than 0 there, and click OK. And those red lines are gone. And let's do it again over here. Zoom in. In most programs, Control R will repeat the last command. So let's hit Control R. And that lowers the amplitude there. And let's do it one more time. Zoom in. Control R. Okay, now we've got rid of our red lines, which is good. Now let's go ahead and save this. Remember, we're exporting, and we'll call this Podcast Test Voice Audacity. But how do we know that this is, in fact, negative 16 LUFS? Audacity doesn't have an amplitude statistics window like Adobe Audition. So let's go to a very cool website that's called loudness.info, and we will select our file from there. And it tells us that it is negative 15.9, which is close enough, negative 16 LUFS. So that is how you save to a loudness of negative 16 LUFS in Audacity. Now let's look at how to do the RMS for an audiobook for ACX. We can go ahead and leave that as mono, double click it, come to Effect, Loudness Normalization, and change this to RMS. And what we're gonna do is put this to the loudest possible. Remember, we have a range here, and it can go all the way up to negative 18 dB. Let's do that because, well, I'll show you why in a second. Click OK, and look at all those red things there. That means that it would clip in those areas, but instead of just individually going to them, let's go ahead because we have a range to work with here, and we will use an effect to limit these peaks to a maximum of negative 3 dB, which is the ACX requirement. So double clicking, make sure it's all selected, go to effect, come all the way down to an effect called limiter, choose soft limit, and put negative 3 in here, and click OK. So that reduced everything to a maximum of negative 3 dB. The question is, did it reduce the overall volume by too much? Well, here's how we find out. File, export, export as MP3, and we're going to call that the Audacity audiobook and save that. And go to our handy loudness.info, select our audiobook file, and we're in there. It didn't turn it down any more than 0.4. So we're in the range of between negative 23 and negative 18. So that is how you set specific loudness in Audacity.